Hello guys, welcome back to ChargerLAB. Today we're going to find a 20 watts very mini charger in those two boxes full of chargers. Because it's really tiny, so it'll take some time. Oops, got it in here. So this charger will be our UGREEN 20W mini PD fast charger, and it's less than $10 on Amazon right now. Let's see whether it's worth it. This charger's model is CD249. It supports 100 to 240 volts 50 or 60 Hz wild voltage input, and the maximum input current is 0.5 amp. It also supports 5 volts 3 amp, 9 volts 2.22 amp, 12 volts 1.67 amp output. And the maximum output power is 20 watts. The manufacturer is Oriental Hero Technology, sold by UGREEN Technology. As for how small this charger is, we can see the size will be 34.5, 30.2, 30 mm, and the weight is about 37 grams. Compared with Apple's original 20W fast charger, if you like UGREEN, you can drop a like. If you prefer Apple, you can leave any comments and give your reasons. Let's use the ChargerLAB Power ZKT002 to test its performance. This charger supports Apple 2.4A, Samsung 5V 2A, DCB Portable, and QC2, QC3, PE2, PD3, PBS Fast Charging Portable. And we can also see it supports 3 fixed videos, 5V 3A, 9V 2.22A, 12V 1.67A. Besides, it also supports 2 PBS videos, 3.3 to 5.9 volts 3A, and 3.3 to 11 volts 1.8A. Just as we know, Apple's original 20W charger actually only supports PD fast charging, even not supports its own Apple 2.4A protocol. Therefore, the compatibility of the UGREEN charger is definitely better than that of Apple. Alright, we have known its appearance, size, and performance. Next, let's tear it down to see what's inside. This charger adopts the most common ultrasonic welding process. It seems like tight and firm. First, try with a spudger to see if it can be opened. Ouch! It's really hard to tear it down. Let's change to the cutting machine. The first thing you can see after opening the shell is two contacts, and the internal PCB module connected the power by them. The whole charger module adopts three PCBs, and they have been welded together. There is one PCB on top and bottom, and a PCB in the middle. There is the transformer, fuse, inductor, etc. Here are two electrolytic capacitors for high voltage filtering. The components on the transformer side are glued. The upper and bottom PCB belong to the secondary and primary sides respectively, with control chip. The middle PCB is mainly used to connect those two PCBs so they can communicate with each other. In other words, the high voltage alternating current comes in from the AC pin, and then after fuse, filter inductance reached to the bridge rectifier. After being filtered by electrolytic capacitor, the master control chip can control the transformer to step down. After the voltage is stepped down, it'll be rectified by the synchronous rectifier chip and filtered by a solid capacitor. Finally, the current will arrive at the output port to charge the mobile phones and other devices under the control of portable chip. This is the basic working SOP of this charger. Next, continue to disassemble the PCB module. There is a 2A fuse at the input, from Sapphire Technology. This rectifier bridge comes from Word Technology. Both electrolytic capacitors for high voltage comes from SZGC. Specification is 400 volts, 12 microfarad. It is a specially customized insulation sleeve to ensure safety, because the capacitor is close to the output. The MOS control chip adopts the highly integrated chip Onbright OB2632. It has built-in controller and high voltage MOS with less components, very suitable for the design of small size chargers. The component layout of the PCB on the secondary side is also very simple. There are only two chips on it. One of them is Onbright's synchronous rectifier chip OB2004Z. This chip has built-in synchronous rectifier controller and MOS, support 3 to 12 volts output. The protocol chip is also Onbright OB2613. This high precision and highly integrated USB PD fast charging chip has passed PD3 and PPS certification and got the Qualcomm QC4 Plus certification at the same time. In addition to UGREEN, this chip is also used by well-known manufacturers such as Dell and Lenovo. A capacitor for synchronous rectifier is on the back of the PCB from APAQ technology, marked with 60 volts 470 microfarad. The V-bus switch tube of USB-C is next to the capacitor. It can cooperate with protocol chip to control the USB-C. There are two SMD components on the middle PCB. There are the SMD capacitors from Treishang and the optocoupler for output voltage feedback. Okay, that will be the entire teardown of UGREEN 20W PD Mini Charger. It is based on Onbright's power chip to develop. The highly integrated AC to DC chip can help the charger smaller. Its protocol chip has multi-protocol and has been certified. It supports multi-device fast charging and performance is very stable. For the size, just as we see, small and compact. Folding pins can help you to store it when traveling. I think it's worth the $10. If you want to buy this charger, feel free to check the link in the description. And you can also see some of our other teardown videos if you're interested. Don't forget to drop a like, give us any feedback about our teardown. Bye!